Today I'm taking my Raspberry Pi 5 to the next level by building the ultimate desktop server. This build will feature an NVMe drive for fast storage, a UPS to keep it running during power cuts, a real-time OLED stats display to show system stats, and of course I'll be designing a custom 3D printed case for it, complete with active cooling for overclocking. Let's start out by taking a look at the hardware that I'm going to use. The Pi 5 is the brain of this project. This is the 8GB variant, so it's got 8GB of LPDDR4 RAM, and a BCM2712 SoC. This has 4 ARM cores running at up to 2.4 GHz. For storage, I'm going to add a 512GB NVMe SSD, which will be connected to the Pi's PCIe port using an NVMe hat. I wanted to keep the design as generic as possible to accommodate a range of NVMe hats, so it will accommodate most hats that are a similar footprint to the Pi and don't need GPIO pins for power. The reason they can't use the GPIO pins is that between the Pi and the NVMe hat, I'm going to install a UPS. This is the Subtronics X1200 UPS that is powered by a USB-C power supply like the Pi. It then passes power through to the Pi using a range of pogo pins that make contact with the test points and GPIO pins underneath it. It stores power in two 18650 cells, which can be used to power the Pi for up to 2 hours in the event of a power outage. Because this hat has so many contact points, it has to be installed underneath the Pi, which means that the NVMe hat needs to be installed either on top of the Pi or below the UPS. I'm going to go with below the UPS so that I can still use an ice tower cooler on the CPU for cooling. This will provide a lot of additional cooling headroom for overclocking. So that's my Pi mini server stack. Now I just need to get a case design for it. Like my previous projects, I modeled the case in Fusion 360. I refined my previous Pi 4 case design to make assembly smoother and to accommodate an increased stack height. The Pi 5 sits on top, with a UPS hat directly underneath it, and then the NVMe hat below that connected via a long PCIe ribbon cable. For the side panels, I'm still using clear acrylic, giving it a sleek look while keeping the internals visible, but the acrylic is now recessed into the side of the case so that the acrylic edges aren't visible. The panels screw into place using M3 screws into brass inserts, making the whole build sturdy and easy to disassemble if needed. I added a button adapter to the back to press the power button on the UPS, and I've added some design features to the sides. This case also features an I2C OLED display, which will be used to display some stats for the Pi 5 and the UPS. With the case design complete, I now need to print out the components. To do that, Elegoo have sent me their new Centauri Carbon Core XY 3D printer to try out. The Centauri Carbon is their first FDM 3D printer with a Core XY motion system. This provides much better precision, stability and speed. It comes fully assembled and ready to print, so you don't need to tinker with leveling the bed, adjusting the belt tension or squaring up the gantry. It has a direct drive extruder and a fully enclosed print volume, which means that it can tackle a wide range of print materials. It also includes automatic bed leveling and a magnetic PEI textured build plate. It doesn't yet support multicolor printing. Filament is mounted onto the side with a filament runout sensor above it. Prints can be started locally using the USB port and full color touchscreen, or they can be sent over Wi-Fi. The printer is aimed at being a low-cost Core XY option, but Elegoo haven't cut corners on quality. It still feels like a well-built machine and even has high-end features like a glass door and top cover. It can tackle a 15-minute benchy and gets pretty good results for the speed. I printed out a couple of other test prints, and aside from a little under-extrusion on the scraper, which can be resolved by dialing in the filament settings, I was quite impressed with the results. These were all out-of-the-box prints with no setup or tinkering, and I didn't have a single print failure. I then prepared my Pi server case print in Elegoo Slicer to be printed from PLA with a 0.16mm layer height. All of the components can easily fit onto the 256mm square build plate, so they can be printed in one go. I've left all of the settings on their defaults, I've only added some supports to the overhang areas, and I've made some changes to the fan grill settings to get the infill pattern to use as the fan mesh. All up, the print should take 2 hours and 45 minutes, and will only use 75 grams of filament. The print can then be sent to the printer over Wi-Fi, or I'll be starting it locally from a connected USB drive. I'm using metallic grey coloured filament for all of the case components. Hopefully that looks good with the clear acrylic side panels. With startup and leveling, the print took a little under 3 hours to complete, but I'm really happy with the quality. The finish is smooth and the layer lines are barely visible. There's some very minor ringing around the button and display cutouts, but you'd have to look hard under bright light to see this. Next, let's make up the side panels from some 2mm laser cut acrylic. These are slightly undersized, so that they fit into the recess that has been designed into each side of the case. I initially made these up without the Pi logo on the side, but I decided the logo outline would look quite nice, so I added that in afterwards. After the supports are removed, to finish the case off, we need to add some M3 brass inserts to the corners, and then one on the inside to hold the display. These are melted into place using a soldering iron. I've already connected a ribbon cable up to the display pins to plug into the Pi's GPIO pins. Remember to take note of the terminal labels, as they'll be hidden once the display is installed. The display slides in under the retaining clips in the body of the case, and then a single screw and bracket secure it. Now we can start assembling the Pi stack to mount into the case. First, let's get the UPS attached to the Pi. Rather than use the included screws, I'm going to use the standoffs from the ice tower cooler. I've trimmed down their thread slightly, because we'll also need to screw another set of standoffs into the bottom of the UPS hat. Below the UPS, I'm using a set of 20mm standoffs that I've also trimmed the thread down on. Next, we can install the ice tower cooler on top of the Pi. I'm going to take the fan off the heatsink, as we'll move this onto the side panel. If you've got thermal paste, this works better than a cooling pad between the CPU and heatsink. If not, or if you plan on removing the cooler frequently, then use the included thermal pad. To finish off the stack, let's install our NVMe drive and then install the hat underneath the Pi. Make sure that you flash your operating system onto the NVMe drive before installing it. I'm using Raspberry Pi OS Bookworm. I'm installing the desktop version for now, but I'll be running an installation of TrueNAS on it long term. The hat closes off access to the batteries, so we'll need to install those first, and then be careful not to short out the contacts on the UPS or press the power button. Better yet, put some thin strips of film between the battery terminals and the UPS contacts, and you can then pull them out before fitting the side panels. This will ensure that the stack remains unpowered. The NVMe hat is held in place with some 8mm standoffs. This gives the drive some room for airflow at the bottom of the case. The button adapter goes into the back of the case, and we can then install the stack. This is held in place with 4 M2.5 screws through the bottom. We can then plug the display into the power and I2C pins on the Pi. Next, let's mount the ice tower fan and fan grill onto the side panel. I've pressed some M3 nuts into the pockets on the back of the fan, and some M3x16mm screws hold it in place. The side panels are held in place with 4 M3x8mm button head screws. I've also got a small 3D printed accent piece around each screw head. On the side with the ports, I've got a 3D printed accent piece that is held in place with some super glue. And that's the case complete and the Pi ready for its first boot. Thank you. All that's left to do is to install the modified stat script, which I've upgraded for this use case. It now cycles between two screens, one showing the system stats like temperature, CPU load and the IP address, and another dedicated to the UPS status, displaying the power state and battery level at a glance. With the UPS and NVMe drive, this Power 5 build is now fast and reliable. The clear acrylic design, optimized cooling, and OLED display make it both functional and great to look at. Let me know what you think of the case design in the comments section below. Also, let me know if you'd like to add any features or change anything up. The modified UPS stats script is available to install from our GitHub repository, which is linked in the video description. I've also added a link to the Elegoo Centauri Carbon, which is available for pre-order from the 17th of February. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more tech and electronics projects, tutorials, and reviews.